Hello and welcome to our final session of Adventuring Through Advent. I do hope you've had a good week, guys. And Jen, I've just got a quick question. You had any John the Baptist breakfast this week? Any crunchy sandwiches?
No, I have to say I really haven't. However brave the vicars were, I am not that brave. Have you, Nick?
I haven't, no. You won't take my fancy either.
It was really interesting last week to look at John the Baptist and all of his interesting habits and things and the massive role that he had to do. He had a really big job, didn't he?
He did.
So this week we are going to have a look at somebody else, another major character, and we think you are going to know all about this person.
I think we're definitely onto something here, aren't we? Let's go and find out more from our friend Kay this time.
Hello, my lovelies. How are you doing? All right? Fabulous. Today, we're thinking about Mary and her role in our Advent preparation and her role in the Christmas story. Firstly, we're going to be looking at a very special messenger. God sent the angel Gabriel to Mary with a wonderful message. It was good news. Mary had been chosen. She was highly favoured. God knew that she was the perfect person for the job. And so Angel Gabriel arrived in Mary's room and said, "Don't be afraid. God's chosen you to have a baby. And you're going to call him Jesus." Now, I don't know if you've ever met an angel. I don't know how you would react to an angel just, you know, bursting into your day. I'm not quite sure how you would have reacted to the news that you were going to have a baby. My first reaction would probably have been, "Seriously?" Followed by, "No." And then, "No, really." And then, "No way." And then, "No thanks, I think not." Well, some people are calm in a crisis, some people aren't. I'll let you decide which one of those I am. But Mary made it clear to the angel Gabriel that she couldn't have a baby. It would be impossible. She wasn't married yet. She was getting ready to get married to Joseph, but she wasn't married and she wasn't ready for a baby. The angel Gabriel told her that everything's possible with God. Everything. Remember her cousin Elizabeth? She couldn't have a baby either. But God had made sure that she was having a baby. He had created a wonderful miracle for Elizabeth, and he would do the same for Mary. She would have a baby called Jesus. Again, I'm not quite sure how you would have reacted to that news. First of all, I can't have a baby. No way. How many times do I need to say no? And actually, if I was to have a baby, I think I'd be choosing my own name. Thank you very much. I don't think I could have kept my cool or been calm in such a situation. I don't know how you would react to such spectacular news, to such fantastical news, to news that you couldn't almost believe. Have you ever had any news that you couldn't quite believe? Well, Mary seemed to take it in her stride. I would have been terrified. I would have been angry. I would have been upset. I would have just been hopping around the place, yelling, "No, it's not going to happen." I don't know about you. God's messenger came. It was really frightening. He told me not to be afraid, but it didn't help. He told me I was most highly favoured and that he had good news for me and that I had been chosen to do a special job. I wasn't sure. And then he told me I was going to have a baby. Impossible. I can't have a baby. It's actually impossible. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know where to look. I was just frozen to the spot.
I told him I couldn't have a baby. But he said, nothing's impossible for God. And he reminded me about my cousin Elizabeth. She couldn't have a baby. For years and years and years she'd wanted to have a baby and couldn't. But now she's expecting a baby. Well, if everything is possible for God, and I've been chosen, and God seems to think that I'm a good person and the right person for the job, well, I said yes. I said, okay, I'll do it.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters?
Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new?
This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Incredible. Right, what would you do if you saw an angel, Nick?
I really don't know, Jen. They're described as being really bright. The shepherds kind of, I think, were a bit like this when they saw angels in the sky as well. I think I'd be a little bit similar to Mary to start with, a bit scared and nervous. It was quite nice, I think, that Angel Gabriel said, don't be afraid. So they obviously know that they're a bit bright and scary initially. I think I'd be a bit frozen on the spot to start with.
I think I'd have the same reaction. Mary must have been terrified and she must have been completely excited too. So she really, really had to trust that God had chosen that she was the right person.
Absolutely.
She really had to put all her trust in God with that one, didn't she?
Absolutely. And yeah, just such a massive thing. And she would have been quite young, wouldn't she, at that time as well, to have this news just suddenly appear to her. But because of her bravery, Jesus was born, just as those prophets had said would happen. And I'm sure you guys have thought of lots of great answers to those I wonder questions you've just done. But it has been so interesting learning about all those different people from the Bible that had an impact, even hundreds and hundreds of years before, on Jesus coming to the earth, didn't they?
Yeah. So together we have journeyed through 4 weeks of Advent. And I think one of the big things that we've learned is that even though sometimes we have to wait a really long time, God will always keep his promises. So for us, Advent isn't just about waiting for the arrival of this little tiny baby Jesus. It's about remembering why Jesus came to the world and how he enables us to be back in a relationship with God.
Absolutely. And we have traditionally got a lovely prayer for you to join in with us just after we finish now. And then we've put a rather nice bouncy Christmas song on for the end of this series. So thank you for listening really well in your classrooms and joining in. And we do hope that you have a really great Christmas with your families. But also remember that really key message of Jesus coming to earth to be with us. Have a fabulous time, guys. And we'll see you again, hopefully, in the future.
Yeah. So Merry Christmas, everybody.
Bye.
Dear God, thank you for Mary, who said yes to the enormous job you chose her to do. As Advent comes to an end, help us to remember that you're a promise-keeping God who loves everyone, which is why you sent Jesus. Bless us and be close to us this Christmas. Amen.